गाइज वेलकम बैक टू माई चैनल। और याद है मैंने चैप्टर 49 के वक्त कहा था कंस्ट्रक्शन चलिए, तो फाइनली अब कंस्ट्रक्शन कहीं जाकर स्टॉप हुई है। अभी भी चली रही थी लाइक 5 मिनट्स अगो, लेकिन शायद अब स्टॉप हुई है। और जैसे ही कंस्ट्रक्शन स्टॉप हुई, मेरे स्ट्रीट डॉग्स, प्यारे स्ट्रीट डॉग्स भौंकने लगे। दे वर हैविंग अ वॉर जस्ट राइट नाउ। आई वॉज लिटरली आई स्टार्टेड एंड दे स्टॉप्ड देयर बार्किंग। सो आई गेस दिस इज अ गुड साइन। We'll be starting with chapter 50. It's not earned. So I am a bit excited कि हमने आधी बुक तो चलो यहाँ तक एटलीस्ट खत्म कर ली है। Seeing Mason hold that Air Force envelope in his hands, I couldn't help but think this was about my future too. But I didn't have time for selfish thoughts. This was about Mason's dreams. Or at least what we thought was his dream. Yeah, of course. Well, go on, open it. Yeah, but what if it's bad news? Then we'll be right here with you. Mason took a deep breath and set his shoulders. And then he tore into the envelope. I watched his face as he read over the first page, trying to decipher his stunned reaction. Was it good, bad, a wait list? Mason, what does it say? Because we are also excited. I got in. I should congratulate him, throw my arms around him. I sequeled and gave him the biggest hug I could manage. Oof, don't go any tighter or you'll break my ribs. Dad, I know you wanted me to get in through football instead. And here's it again started. So I'll just pause this and wait for it to end. I might not be the star quarterback anymore. You know that, right? Getting to be part of the Air Force is the most important thing. When do they want to meet to talk logistics? Tomorrow, at an aircraft carrier near the coast, I can bring a guest. Perfect. I can't wait to show you around. Well, actually, I had planned to bring Addy. I said I had helped her take more pictures for the silent auction. Right, Addy? I looked at Master in confusion, but he nudged me, clearly desperate for me to play along. Yeah, I think a change of scenery would help inspire me. I was hoping to share that experience with you, Mason. But if that's what you want, enjoy your field trip. Principal Jennings headed inside without another word. Mason turned to me, relieved. Thanks for that, Addy. It's been weird. Since when did he stop caring about football? He's always been insistent on me taking his place as Air Force Academy quarterback. Who knows, maybe he finally saw how much your own path means to you. Yeah, of course, maybe he saw. The next day, we were in Mason's car, heading south for the coast. I was excited for Mason, but this trip was a bittersweet reminder that we had each be going somewhere next year. Man, I'm still pinching myself to check if I'm dreaming. My dad made me feel like getting in was a long shot. Mason, don't sell yourself. It had been relieved not living under the same roof as him soon, huh? You put in the work. I saw it firsthand on that plane yesterday. Thanks for going along with all that of fun. Sudden. It was really important to me to share that part of my life with you. No, I'm glad you did. Now I'll know what it feels like when you are flying. Mason reached over and rested his hand on my knee. With a smile, I took it in my own. But I had an uneasy feeling I was forgetting something. And then my phone buzzed with a text. So, about that college tour thing I was asking about. Oh crap. You should have reminded me. I'm so sorry. I totally forgot to get back to you about it. I goofed big time. Please forgive me. Lol. Dude, it's okay. I forget. It's not like we had made any concrete plans yet. I feel bad. Are you mad? No way. Promise. Extra supreme, super extreme promise. I'm actually at college tour RN, lol. We'll make up for it some other time. It's no biggie. Well, even through text, I could tell Ava was being genuine when she said she wasn't mad. And this sort of thing happened all the time. Why was it then that I look out, our exit is coming up. Well, traffic was light, so we arrived at the carrier about half an hour early before our scheduled meeting. As I scanned our surroundings, I couldn't help but be in awe as of the scale of the thing. Wow, this aircraft carrier makes the planes look tiny. I know the photo thing was an excuse, but I really should take me as many pictures as I can of this place while we are here. Yeah, I bet no one else is gonna be submitting photos of an aircraft carrier to the silent auction. Need a model? I'd love to pose for you and have a bit of fun while we are waiting for the recruiter to show. This was my chance to get some unique photos and confide in him, but my worries for our future too. Well, let's kill some time with the photo shoot. Yeah. Let's do it. We are waiting anyway. Consider me a model. Where would you like me? Post up near that fighter jet. It will frame you real nice. Once he was in position, I uncapped my camera and held it up. Should I do anything? Do a classic crisp salute? Top gun pose? No. Salute. Stand at attention. Cadet. My centurion to touch the tips of his fingers or to the brim of his hat and give me a stern expression. Well. Great. For the next one, let's face this way instead. I situated us so we were looking back near the coast. As Mason posed and I took pictures, I tried to think of something to say. So, this is where you want to be in a few years, huh? Isn't it great? The sea air, the travel, and did you see that fighter jet back there? Yeah, it's all pretty wild. I tried to keep this idea. Against the railing. The water lapped against the side of the boat. Mason, we won't get to the college together. We won't get to go to the college together. We've never been apart more than a summer. How are you gonna handle being away for months at a time? Remember, when we were 7, you once called me because you thought there was a monster in your closet. I'm sure we'll live. We have modern technology on our side now. We can video chat every day if you want. It's not the same though. Won't you get lonely? I might, but we are all still figuring out what we want, aren't we? He must have been alluding to my inability to choose between him and no. With Ava in the picture now, he didn't even know the half of it yet. But he was right. I was still figuring that out. Yeah, being seniors in high school will do that to you. Too many choices. I'll miss you like crazy, but I'm really happy you found something you want. You deserve to carve your own path. Thanks, but I don't know if I would have had the courage if it wasn't for you. The way he looked at me made my face burn. The way his eyes softened at the corners, his lips like he didn't even know he was smiling. That's very smooth. You should follow up with a kiss. But don't say that in your interview. Oh, good thing I can take an order. Mason dipped me and seaside air kept blowing my hair in our faces as we kissed. Ugh, sorry. Let's try that again. Mason tenderly brushed my face with his fingers, tucking a stray hair behind my ear. Then he wrapped me in his arms and shielded me from the wind. I melted against him as our lips met in a warm, sweet kiss. When we eventually broke apart, I snuggled into his jacket, wanting to stay in that moment as long as I could. You don't have to worry. After we took a few more photos, the recruiter showed up. Mason Jennings, I am Airman Rogers and your friend is... I am Addie Price. Nice to meet you both. If you'll just follow me, I'd be happy to give you some of the materials to read over, Mason. I'm so honored to be here. I can't believe I'm at a dream school. The pleasure is ours. You're an exceptionally talented young man and I'm sure we both know how convincing your father can be. Mason's head froze over the folder. The A-man had slid across the desk. What does that mean? My father spoke with you. We are always happy to discuss concerns with parents. It's a big decision after all. Mason's brow furrowed. Did Principal Jennings have a hand in this admission, in his admission too? Right, thanks. I'll interview everything and fill out the paperwork. Of course, looking forward to having you on the team, Mason. Well, if it isn't your ability but your father's name or reputation. We exited the office and I could see the change on Mason's face in the clear light of the day. I hooked my arm around his. Mason, don't dwell on this. You really impressed him. I am so proud of you. Why should you be? Maybe I didn't earn this. Mason, don't let your dad ruin this for you. You would have gotten in even without him. Going too bad for you. I wish I could believe that. Let's just hope. The ride home was quiet. A completely different Mason at the wheel than the one who was so excited early that morning. And the worst part was, I couldn't fix it. Well, Mason wasn't the only one thinking about his future. I had been taking pictures every spare moment I could for the silent auction. When photography club came around, I was nervous to share what I had. What can you share with us today? Shakily, I pulled my latest photos out of my bag. Adi, you're going to kill at that auction with these. Just a minute, guys. Are those black and white? Look who's trying to look all deep and historic here. I feel like people only resort to grayscale when their original pictures wasn't that good. My cheeks burnt and I felt something twist in my stomach. To my relief, I was jumped to my defense. That's not true. Hell, you two both had black and white pictures last week. Yeah, you're only mad because it's good. But Mrs. Lauren was so quiet. She had been so much potential in me. I had already let her down. Mrs. Lassen, are they really that bad? I know I can do better. I didn't feel great about this patch. I'm sure the next one will be. Adi, as artists, we have to be comfortable letting our art speak for itself. But I'm afraid we are just Adi, stay a moment. There's something we need to discuss. Well, it's a suspense again and the story is... This chapter is over. Thank you guys for being with me in chapter 50 and I hope you like it. I will upload chapter 51 soon. But till then, bye-bye. And reminder, we completed 50% of this chapter, of this book today. So, it's a great achievement. Thank you. Bye.